I recently posted a quick tutorial on an LED mask project. It's really taken off in popularity, so today I'm going to show you a more detailed tutorial with a pattern specifically made for this mask. If you missed my first video on the mask, 2 weeks ago I created a quick mask prototype using my Flex LED matrix panels that can respond to your phone's microphone or display text and images. I used an existing pattern and went through the tutorial pretty quickly, but because of the popularity, I went back and refined my own pattern. If you can't sew or don't have a sewing machine, I've also put this mask on the production line to order ready-made, and it'll be shipping in May 2020. The main questions I've had on this mask are, first of all, how do you clean the electronics, and second of all, how do you breathe? I mentioned it in the first video, but the electronics are easily removable. You can still breathe, but it isn't as ideal as a regular cotton mask, but the nice thing about this pattern is if that you want a more practical mask, you can remove the electronics at any time for a normal mask, or even add in a filter for more serious protection. But again, as a disclaimer, this is a fun project and not intended to be used as serious protection. There are plenty of other experts on masks and safety, and this was really just a way to bring a bit of dystopian style to a tough situation. This pattern includes a pocket for the battery to go inside. It requires two types of fabric, a heavy cotton fabric and a semi-transparent fabric, as well as some elastic. Sometimes supplies are a little bit hard to come by right now, and I've had a few questions on what fabric to use. I ended up ordering bed sheets and curtains on Amazon, which will be linked in the description if you want to use them, and they worked really well for this pattern. I used the large panel available on wearabletutorials.com, but you can also make this mask with the smaller version. It works just as well with just a little bit of surface area. You may also want to add in a few extra stitches to hold it in position better if you decide to use the small panel. First of all, you'll want to download my pattern, the link will be below, and cut out three pieces of fabric. One of the thick black fabric, one of the semi-sheer fabric, and one smaller piece of the same thick black fabric. Fold the two large pieces down the middle. In this video, I'm going to be using some different colored fabrics. This isn't because I've lost my mind and thinks this looks good, it's because I first filmed this whole tutorial using black fabrics and realized that since everything was black, it was impossible to see what I was doing. So this tan fabric represents the heavy cotton, this ugly pink fabric is the semi-transparent fabric, and the small black piece is also the heavy cotton fabric. Fold the large pieces of fabric and line them up with the fold line on the pattern. You'll also want to add that little piece to line up with the line on the pattern. Pin them all together and carefully cut them out. This pocket part is really the only complicated part of the tutorial. What you're going to do now is finish the edges of the pocket and the edge of the heavy cotton layer. If you're using a sewing machine, you'll want to fold them, iron them, and stitch down the edges. If you have a serger, it's even easier and you can just serge right onto the edge. You're going to take about half an inch off the edge of the heavy piece, so at the end you have a little overlapping pocket that opens up on both sides. One side for the matrix panel and one side for the battery. Once you have those edges finished, carefully line everything back up so that there is overlap in the pockets. Pin everything all back together. Stitch or serge all the way around the edges of the entire mask. Once that's all done, through the pocket, flip everything around inside out. You probably want to use an iron to flatten out the mask again. Now fold the mask in half again with the semi-sheer layer on the inside and the heavy layer on the outside. Now we're going to stitch in the darts for your nose and your chin. You'll be stitching on the heavy cotton side so that when you flip it inside out, the semi-sheer fabric is on the outside. Stitch in the edges in the corner as displayed on the pattern, being careful not to stitch too far down or the panel won't fit inside. If everything worked well, you should now have a mask. You'll want to add one more little stitch for the battery pocket, stitching about two-thirds up the way on the small pocket side to hold the battery in. All that's left to do now is add the elastic. You can add the elastic to go around each ear or all the way around the back of your head. It's up to you. The length of the elastic you use will depend on how stretchy your elastic is. I used about 3 inches per side for mine. Slip in the panel and tuck the battery into the pocket and you're done. Thanks for watching, and I hope this tutorial brings a bit of fun in strange and scary times. Take care of yourself and stay safe and creative.